Some of the key issues that were discussed around the OTT or over the top related to the economic and policy issues or regulatory environment for OTTs, and reviewed some of the work that is being done in the ITU study group on economic, financial, and policy issues, and noted the report that we published on the impacts of OTTs from a balanced perspective. But also, the CTOs discussed how OTTs would be deployed in the 5G network, and that some regulatory implications are still to be addressed, for example, in deploying small cells. There needs to be an enabling environment for the regulation to allow for that. Otherwise, the economic model would not hold. The other aspect of OTTs was around security. Today, OTTs are being used to carry and provide services for energy, for financial services, some really critical services for humans around the world. And so we need to pay a lot of attention to how secure those transactions are. So the CTOs recognize that there may be some security gaps or vulnerabilities, and that as we deploy 5G networks, we need to look at the security aspects of OTT more carefully and provide for the mechanisms. So they called on the study group on security to address these issues in the future. Yes, as you know, the ITU deployed many years ago the international standard on public key distribution, the X500 series of standards. And today, most of the encryption on the internet and the network is based on that protocol. However, due to the quantum computing, the algorithms that are the foundation of those crypto encryptions become vulnerable and can be broken very rapidly with a quantum computer. And so the CTOs discussed how the quantum key distribution would play a key role to address that security vulnerability, and noted that a study group on security in the ITU just approved two New York items on quantum key distribution, as well as the quantum number generator to be used in this distribution. So those are new exciting areas that will enhance security in the 5G network and beyond. When we look at the smart cities, the CTOs recognize that the platform that the ITU and 16 other UN agencies are providing, called the United for Smart Sustainable Cities, is providing a unique platform to address the key performance indicators of cities and the dialogue on how the data that's coming from the cities needs to be interoperable across vectors, verticals. For instance, if we look at the IoT application in transportation and the data that comes from it, today is kind of siloed in that vertical. Then the data in the health sector and the data in the transportation sector and so on, each one is siloed. And that would not allow for smart algorithms and decision-based data-based decision-making to be done. So the CTOs called for more attention to the data formats, the data interoperability, and how that could enable really true, smart, safe, and sustainable cities in the future. The digital financial services is a topic that the ITU has been addressing since 2014, where we published about 28 reports and 85 regulatory recommendations. Out of that, we have now an initiative called FIGI, Financial Inclusion Global Initiative. It's an initiative in partnership with the World Bank and CPMI, and it's funded, supported by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And Fiji is looking at deploying some of those recommendations into three countries, three implementation countries. One aspect of that deployment is addressing the quality of service of the network. Because if we don't have a reliable network, the financial transaction may not go through. And as you know, these transactions are going over mobile networks. And in many developing countries, the mobile network quality may not be really conducive to a complete transaction, financial transaction. So the CTOs looked at the work being done in the Financial Inclusion Global Initiative on the security aspects of it, as well as the quality of service of the network that needs to be done. We're conducting measurements in Ghana and in Egypt on the quality of service, and we are hoping that through those measurements we can come back to the Fiji initiative and share those findings, as well as come back to the study group in ITU on quality of service and performance, quality of experience, study group 12, to maybe enhance the standards and the guidelines for the future. Yes, the having the CTO meeting back-to-back with the telecom world is a really unique opportunity because the schedule of the CTOs and the executives is quite busy. So combining a trip to the telecom world and to the CTO meeting is quite worthwhile. And it's an opportunity for the CTOs that come to also be exposed to other other topics like MVNOs, MVNEs, new financial services in the smart city domain, digital fiat currencies. So these are very exciting topics in the smart ABC, we call artificial intelligence, banking, and cities. And that linkage and synergy between the CTO and the industry executives and the broader telecom participation is quite fruitful. Well, I think one of the clear dynamic that we saw in the CTO meeting is that there is a lot of emphasis on the new topics and how ITU can be a unique multilateral neutral platform between governments and private sector to accelerate developing standards, guidelines, and to really address some of these really challenging and complex topics in the ICT domain.